Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Scuba Science. Today we are going to talk about depth. Human beings are explorers at heart, and nowhere else does that show more than in scuba diving. But what is the deepest that human beings can reasonably scuba dive? In this episode, I'm going to try and paint a picture of how deep human beings can reasonably scuba dive, ranging from the average recreational diver to the most extreme experiments. This program is completely self-funded, but if you want to support scuba science, you can always pick up some Dive Saga merch. I will put a link below. And of course, you can also like the video and subscribe. Water pressure increases with depth at a rate of about 1 atmosphere every 10 meters. There is also already an atmosphere of pressure present at sea level, meaning that at 10 meters, 33 feet, we will experience 2 atmospheres of pressure. For every additional 10 meters, 33 feet, we will experience an additional atmosphere of pressure. That means that, for example, at 40 meters, 130 feet, the human body will experience 5 times the ambient pressure that we normally feel in the atmosphere. This is important because the deeper we scuba dive, the higher the pressure effects on our body. The gases we breathe will also have their characteristics be amplified by the same factor. As discussed in our video about the gases of scuba diving, most recreational divers will use air, which contains 21% oxygen, 78% nitrogen, and 1% of residual gases. At greater depths, this gas becomes unusable because nitrogen has extremely narcotic effects and oxygen becomes toxic. So neither the oxygen nor the nitrogen are really desirable. So different gas mixes need to be used to achieve greater depths. Once again, there is a video on this channel called The Gases of Scuba Diving that you can watch if you need further clarification on this topic. Let's start at the beginning. Most recreational training agencies will set a depth limit for initial certification somewhere around 18 to 20 meters, 60 feet. But for most scuba divers with some advanced training, you should be able to reach depths of 40 meters, 130 feet, with some additional certification, but no overly complex procedures. It is worth mentioning that most recreational training agencies will not consider decompression diving something recreational, which means that in order to dive to greater depths, you will need to engage in technical diver training. It is worth mentioning that most interesting fauna and flora underwater situates itself relatively close to the surface, where photosynthesis is optimal because light penetrates easily. This is also why, for most scuba divers, this maximum depth of 40 meters, 130 feet, is more than what they will ever need, and the risks simply do not outweigh the rewards. Technical diving takes this a step further, and it is available to most scuba divers. Once you are extremely proficient in your regular recreational scuba diving skills and knowledge, it is possible to enroll in a technical diver training course. Technical divers learn equipment redundancy, knowledge, and skills that are more advanced and enable them to get home safely. When we engage in a technical dive, we essentially agree to a dive profile that requires us to stop on the way up in order to avoid decompression sickness. We discussed decompression sickness at length in our video about the dangers of scuba diving. A diver committing to a dive that requires decompression stops and then failing to perform those may get seriously injured or die. Most entry-level technical training will set the limit somewhere between 50 and 70 meters, or 160 to 230 feet. The reason the limit is set there is because we can still use what's called normoxic trimix, or at least a trimix with a reasonable amount of oxygen that allows us to also breathe that gas at the surface if necessary. Once again, in our episode about the gases of scuba diving, we go into depth what normoxic and hypoxic trimix actually means. If divers want to dive deeper, they will need to start using what's called hypoxic trimix. This is a gas mix of helium, oxygen, and nitrogen that contains less than 21% oxygen, often below 18%, which is the minimum that's required to sustain consciousness at the surface. Helium is a non-narcotic gas, so it allows us to focus more on the task at hand, and it also isn't toxic in the way that oxygen is. But diving to depths of 100 meters, 330 feet or more require extreme training and extreme proficiency in our diving skills and knowledge. It is not a normal progression for all scuba divers. Commercial and military divers will use a diving technique that is called saturation diving. In saturation diving, the divers will actually live in a pressurized environment, whether they are in or out of the water. This avoids the need to make those decompression stops and gas switches after every dive, because the diver simply remains at the depth that they are working at. This enables divers to go as deep as 200 to even 300 meters, 600 to 900 feet, without the need for decompression stops. This can be necessary for complicated projects such as infrastructure repair or construction work underwater. The human body simply isn't made to be under such a huge amount of enormous pressure. Gas narcosis, as mentioned earlier and as mentioned in our video about the dangers of scuba diving, impairs our judgment and can cause a false sense of euphoria. Oxygen toxicity, on the other hand, can cause convulsions, which causes us to spit out our scuba regulator, inhale water, and drown. Decompression sickness, which results from an excessive amount of inert gas in our tissues that we fail to off-gas at a reasonable rate upon ascent, can cause serious injuries, paralysis, and death. And high-pressure nervous syndrome, which is caused by helium-based mixes beyond 150 meters, 500 feet, can cause tremors and impaired judgment. So as you can see, there are some serious barriers to ultra-deep diving. But of course, diving pioneers have repeatedly pushed the limits of what human beings can do in achieving greater and greater depths, setting astounding records in the process. For instance, although not scuba diving, because freediving does not use scuba equipment, it is worth mentioning the deepest breath hold dive a human being has ever achieved. As it stands at the making of this video, the no limit freediving record is 253.2 meters or 831 feet. This record was set by Herbert Nitsch in Santorini in Greece on June 6, 2012. It is worth mentioning that Nitsch suffered from severe decompression issues and retired from freediving after he broke this record. The deepest open circuit scuba dive took place in 2014. Egyptian diver Ahmed Gabir achieved the deepest scuba dive on record, reaching an astonishing depth of 332.35 meters or 1,090 feet. This took place in the Red Sea. The descent took several minutes, but the ascent, which is more interesting in my opinion, took 15 hours to complete with a complicated series of extensive decompression stops. It is important to realize that Ahmed Gabir trained for this for years, and it of course involves extremely difficult logistics, gas management, and always the risk of death. The deepest rebreather dive currently stands at 316 meters. That's 1,037 feet. This record was set by Jarek Macedonski in Lake Garda in Italy on October 10, 2018. It is worth noting that this diver also broke the record for deepest dive on a diver propulsion vehicle and the deepest freshwater dive. The deepest cave dive was conducted by Xavier Meniscus in January of 2024. Meniscus dove to a depth of 312 meters or 1,023 feet in the Fonds Estramar in France. By doing this dive, he beat the previous record of Frederik Swirzinski, which was set at 308 meters. But it is worth noting that these two gentlemen seem to be going back and forth a little bit, so we might see that depth record broken in the foreseeable future. The deepest open sea saturation dive was achieved in 1988 by a team of COMEX and French Navy divers who performed pipeline connection exercises at a depth of 534 meters. That's 1,750 feet. They achieved this in the Mediterranean Sea during a project called Hydra 8. To break this record, they had to employ gases such as heliox and hydrox, highly complicated gases about which you can once again learn more in our Gases of Scuba Diving episode. On November 20th, 1992, COMEX led a project called Hydra 10, during which they simulated a dive in an onshore hyperbaric chamber using hydreliox as the gas mix, which is a mixture of hydrogen, helium and oxygen. On that dive, Theo Mavrostomos set a record in a simulated dive for 2 hours at a depth of 701 meters, 2,300 feet. Scuba diving offers a gateway to the underwater world, but it certainly also challenges the limits of our human existence, not in the least of our precious human body. Pioneers like Ahmed Gaber, for instance, certainly demonstrate what is possible when we apply ourselves to pushing these boundaries. And as we look into the future and longer explorations become achievable, we may yet see all these limits pushed further. But the risks of extreme pressure on our bodies and the complexity of breathing gases and their associated risks remind us frequently that somehow we are much more able to explore the vastness of outer space than the depths of our oceans right here at home. At least until we make more advances in scuba science.